Bioactive. What's the deal? What's it mean? In this video, we're gonna talk about what makes a setup bioactive. Hey everyone, Kevin Pangea here to talk about bioactive enclosures. Technically, as soon as you put an animal in an enclosure, you have inserted a biological entity into that habitat, making it bioactive. In the terrarium hobby and herpetoculture, we usually use this term referring to other elements inside the enclosure that go into creating a small ecosystem. For most, having detritivores like isopods and springtails is a determining factor into making an enclosure bioactive. These little critters eat decaying matter, also known as detritus, like leaves, wood, in addition to the leftover food and animal waste. They work as a cleanup crew, making enclosure maintenance much easier. For others, integrating live plants in addition to detritivores makes the setup fully bioactive. However, not all environments or reptiles allow for live plants. Some habitats make keeping live plants very difficult, while many plants are too fragile to handle careless reptiles trampling them. These elements help create a habitat closer to the animal's natural habitat, but the secret stars of bioactive enclosures are mycelium and bacteria. They help convert broken down waste into usable nutrients for your plants and less toxic chemicals for your reptile or amphibian. Mycelium is the fungal network that you may see as a thin white web structure in your substrate. This network breaks down detritus and plays a huge role in providing nutrients for plants and the microfauna in your terrarium, ultimately forming a mycorrhizal network that forms a positive symbiosis with the neighboring plants. Bacteria, like fungus, can be difficult to see as beneficial, and often it isn't. However, some bacteria is crucial to converting nitrogen and ammonia into usable nutrients for your plants and creating a safe environment for your reptile or amphibian. With time, it's natural for beneficial bacteria and mycelium to appear in your bioactive enclosure along with the natural elements you've put inside. That's a large reason why we recommend allowing your bioactive setup to establish before putting a reptile or amphibian in your enclosure, along with letting the plants properly root and your microfauna colonies to find a balance within your micro ecosystem. We hope you learned something new watching this today. Let us know what you learned or what you're still curious about in the comments, and give us a like and a follow for some more bioactive content from Pangea Reptile. And you know where to find your wood, your substrate, your microfauna, and everything else you need to set up your next bioactive enclosure at pangeareptile.com.